Oh, we're ready? Hi, I'm Laura Virili, and I inspire advisors to kill it online through social media and offline through relationship management. In today's episode, I'm going to share with you how to create a pipeline. So you're time blocking and you're sourcing names on LinkedIn from your connections. And if you're unsure as to what I'm talking about, pause this video and back up to the previous episode so that you know how to source names from your connections, and then rejoin me here. And then for those of you that know exactly what I'm talking about, we're going to create a custom pipeline. The great thing about this is that A, you don't even need to be connected to these individuals. They don't have to be first degree, second degree, third degree connections. They can be anyone that you can put in your pipeline. And the other great thing is, that would be B, they don't know that you are doing this. It's only visible to you. So let's go over live on LinkedIn and I will walk you through exactly how you create a custom pipeline. So I've looked at my connections and I have found a person that I feel is very interesting and have pre-qualified him as an absolute A-list prospect. The first thing that I'm going to do is I'm going to save him as a contact. In order to do that, I have to click on the star underneath his picture. If you don't see that star, what you need to do is hit F5 on your keyboard. F5 refreshes the screen and it enables that relationship and contact information feature to appear. I've now saved Craig to my contacts, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to add information to him. I can add a note, I can add a reminder, I can say how we've met if we in fact did, but in order to create a pipeline, I'm actually going to tag him. He is absolutely an A-list prospect. You're going to notice I have quite a few tags here. That's because I've created them. I'm also going to create a new tag because I noticed in his profile that he enjoys golfing. So I'm going to create a golf tag. And the reason why I'm going to do that is in the future, if I'm having a golf outing event, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and look at the individuals that enjoy golf to then, of course, invite them to the golf outing. So I'm going to hit save here. And I have now placed two tags on Craig. He's now an A-list prospect and he has this golf tag. You can, again, do multiple tags. If he was also a wine lover, I could add that as well. So you've created these wonderful tags on all the prospects that you would like to be introduced to. Another key thing that I'd like to share with you is if this individual is a second degree connection of a client of yours, I would add in the client's name as well. And how do you do that? Well, you go to tag, just like I added golf. What I'm going to do is I am going to add the client's name. So I'm going to add a new tag and I'm going to type in John Smith, because John Smith is my client. Now I'm going to hit save. I now have all the tags that I'd like associated with Craig. And I'm going to go over and take a look at my pipeline because you're probably wondering, okay, you've done this great tagging, where does it live? You go up to connections, click on that in the black bar on the top of the screen, right here. And once the page loads, what you're going to do is you're going to come down here into this white section. LinkedIn defaults to sort by recent conversation and filter by all contacts. What we're going to do is we're going to filter by tag. And in this case, I'm going to be looking at A-list prospects only. I click on A-list prospects and all of my A-list prospects appear, including my brand new individual, Craig, is listed in here. I can also go back up here because next weekend I'm going to be having a wine tasting event. I can go down here and look at my wine tags and then these individuals will appear that I tagged as wine lovers. So there you have it. Now you know how to save individuals as contacts and then tag them to create your own pipeline. Again, you can multi-tag individuals and then all you simply need to do is go into connections and filter by, tag, and then the names that you've given them. So now you know how to create a custom pipeline using the tag feature in LinkedIn. If you need a little refresher, click on the quick reference guide below and it will take you through step by step exactly what I covered today. And for more great information on how to kill it online and off, be sure to tune in to future episodes and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for joining. Today, I'm going to show you exactly how you can use it if you don't know how to use it. And I don't know what I'm talking about, but we're going to start over. In today's episode, I'm going to teach you how to create a pipeline. If you've been tooling around LinkedIn, because you know we all drive around the web and all that good stuff. Oh my God, it just sounded like Wilma or Betty from the Betty Rubble. It sounded like Betty Rubble.
It was.
It's excellent. Yeah, it's fabulous.
Blonde Betty Rubble.